The Broadway Theater Archive.
If I could be any one of us.
Not real one.
Don't you dare say I'm dependent upon you, because I'm not.
I truly speak to you.
Of all the pain.
No good role for this actor.
A woman who cannot keep her lust under control.
A collection of comedy and drama available on videocassette. BroadwayArchive.com.
Tonight on Great Performances, Lewis Carroll's classic tale, Alice in Wonderland, with Kate Burton as Alice, Richard Burton as the White Knight, and featuring Eve Arden, Jimmy Coco, Donald O'Connor, Maureen Stapleton, Colleen Dewhurst, Kay Ballard, Fritz Weaver, Jeffrey Holder, Andre Gregory, and Austin Pendleton. Join us as we journey with Alice on her fantastic adventures in Wonderland.
Yeah, a little more to the left. Just a little. Hey, watch it, Bimbo!
I told you to move that
guy over the window. You nearly killed that guy.
I don't care.
Hey, wait,
you
gotta bring him back.
No, we gotta bring him back.
This woman needs a coffee.
Will everyone please be quiet? Now, I will make the decision. The girl has got to go on.
Go on. Look, sweetheart, I'm the director. I told you, I'm getting mad. She does not know the part. It'll be a disaster.
If she messes up my scenes, I'll walk off the stage.
Now, I just wish somebody would listen to my wife. She knows what she's talking about. This girl must go on, even if she carries the script. Isn't that a good idea, darling?
Dreadful idea.
But, curtain time is in 20 minutes, and we're going to be late.
Late?
20 minutes!
Can somebody get
some
coffee?
Slightly toes, gyre and gimbal in the wabe, all mimsy were the borogoves and the mome raths outgrabe. Beware the jabberwock. Beware the jabberwock, my son, the jaws that bite. Claws that catch, beware the jub-jub bird and shun. From his bandersnatch, he took his vorpal sword and hand laid down the maxim bows. So rested he by the tum-tum tree and stood a while in thought. And as an effish thought, he stood the jabberwock with eyes aflame, came whiffling through the tulgy wood. And
20
and
minutes till curtain.
Oh!
My ears and whiskers. How late it's getting.
If you please, sir. Dear, dear, how queer everything is today. Yesterday, things went on just as usual. Wonder if I've changed in the night. Let me think, was I the same when I woke up this morning? I almost think I can remember feeling a little different. But if I'm not the same, the next question is, who in the world am I? I'm certain this table was not here before. Drink me. Well, it's all very well to say drink me, but I better look first and see whether you're marked poison or not. For if a little girl drinks from a bottle marked poison, it is almost certain to disagree with her sooner or later. Now, must be all right. I must be shutting up like a telescope. I am. I wonder if I shall go out altogether, like a candle. Oh, no! I hadn't cried so much. I shall be punished for it now, I suppose, by being drowned in my own tears. Would it be of any use now to speak to this mouse? Everything's so out of the way here that I think it quite likely it can talk. At any rate, there's no harm in trying. Oh, mouse, do you know the way out of this pool? I'm very tired of swimming about here, oh mouse. Perhaps it doesn't understand English. I dare say it's a French mouse come over with William the Conqueror. Où est ma chatte? Oh, I beg your pardon. Oh, I quite forgot you didn't like cats.
Would you like cats if you were me?
Oh, no, indeed. And don't be angry about it, for I wish I could show you our cat, Dinah. She is such a dear, quiet thing, and she is such a capital one for catching mice. I beg your pardon. We won't talk about her anymore if you'd rather not.
We indeed. As if I would talk on such a subject. You see, our family always hated cats. Nasty, low, vulgar things. Don't let me hear that name again.
Oh, Mouse, please do come back again.
Well, let us get to shore, and then I'll tell you my history, and you'll understand why it is I hate you know.
You promised to tell me your history and why it is you hate me.
Mine is a long and a sad tale.
It is a long tale, certainly, but why do you call it sad?
Fury said to a mouse that he met in the house, "Let us both go to law. I will prosecute you. Come, I'll take no denial. We must have a trial. For really this morning I've nothing to do," said the mouse to the cur. "Such a trial, dear sir, with no jury or judge, would be wasting our breath. I'll be judge, I'll be jury," said cunning old Fury. "I'll try the whole cause and condemn you to You're not attending.
I beg your pardon. You had got to the fifth bend, I think.
I had not.
A knot? Oh, do let me help to undo it.
I shall do nothing of the sort. Oh, the Duchess. The Duchess. Won't she be savage? I kept her waiting. Oh, my dear paws. Oh, my furs and whiskers. She'll have me executed. As sure as ferrets are ferrets. Now, where could I have dropped? Why, Marianne, what are you doing here? Run home and fetch me a pair of gloves and a fan. Quick now.
He took me for his housemate.
How surprised he'll be when he finds out who I am. But I better take him his fan and gloves. That is, if I can find them. Hardly know, sir, just at present. At least, I know who I was when I woke up this morning. I'm afraid I've changed several times since then.
What do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
Well, I can't explain myself, I'm afraid, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
I don't see.
I can't put it more clearly than that, for I can't understand it myself, and being so many different sizes in one day is terribly confusing.
It isn't.
Well, perhaps you haven't found it so yet. But when you have to turn into a chrysalis, and then after that into a butterfly, I should think you'll feel it a little queer, won't you?
Not a bit.
Well, perhaps your feelings may be different. All I know is it would feel very queer to me.
To you? Who are you?
I think you ought to tell me who you are first.
Oh. Why? Come back, come back. I have something to say. Keep your temper.
Is that all?
No. So you think you're changed, do you?
I'm afraid I am, sir. I can't remember things as I used, and I don't keep the same size for 10 minutes together.
Can't remember. What things?
Well, I tried to say how doth the little busy bee, but it all came different.
Ah. Repeat. You are old Father William.
You are old Father William, the young man said, and your hair has become very white.
Oh.
And yet you incessantly stand on your head. Do you think at your age it is right? In my youth, Father William replied to his son, I feared it would injure the brain. But now that I'm perfectly sure I have none, why, I do it again and again.
That's not said right.
Well, not quite right, I'm afraid, sir. Some of the words have got altered.
It's wrong from beginning to end. What size do you want to be?
Well, I'm not particular as to size, sir. Only one doesn't like changing so often, you know.
I don't know. Are you content now?
Well, I should like to be a little larger, sir, if you wouldn't mind. 3 inches is such a wretched height to be.
It is a very good height indeed.
But I'm not used to it.
Then you'll get used to it in time. Oh. One side will make you grow taller, and the other side will make you grow smaller.
One side of what? The other side of what?
Of the mushroom.
Oh. Which is which?
Thank you.
Duchess!
For the Duchess!
Yeah, get away from me.
An invitation from the Queen to play croquet.
From the Queen?
From the Queen.
An invitation for the Duchess to play croquet?
Please, sir.
To play croquet? To play croquet? There's no sort of use in knocking, and that's for two reasons. First, because I'm on the same side of the door as you are. Secondly, because they're making such a noise inside, no one could possibly hear you.
Please, then, how am I to get in?
There might be some sense in your knocking if we had the door between us. For instance, if you were inside, you might knock, and I could let you
in. How am I?
I shall sit here till tomorrow. Or next day, maybe.
But how am I to get in?
I shall sit here on and off for days and days.
There's no use in talking to him. He's perfectly idiotic.
Too much pepper in that soup.
Would you tell me, please? Why does your cat grin like that?
It's a Cheshire cat. That's why. Pig.
Well, I didn't know the Cheshire cats always grinned. In fact, I didn't know the cats could grin.
They all can, and most of them do.
Well, I don't know of any that do.
You don't know much, and that's a fact. Minded their own business, the world would go a deal faster than it does.
This would not be an advantage. Just think of all the work it would make with the day and the night. You see, the Earth takes 24 hours to turn round on its axis.
Talking of axes, chop off her head.
24 hours, I think, or is it 12?
Oh, don't bother me. I never could abide figures. Speak roughly to boy, and beat him when he sneezes. He only does it to annoy, because he knows it teases. I speak severely to my boy. I beat him when he sneezes, for he can thoroughly enjoy the pepper when he sneezes. Here, you may nurse him a bit if you like. I must go and get ready to play croquet with the Queen.
If I don't take this child away with me, they'll surely kill it in a day or two. Wouldn't it be murder to leave it behind? Don't grunt. That's not at all the proper way of expressing yourself. If you're gonna turn into a pig, my dear, I'll have nothing more to do with this. What am I gonna do with this creature once I get it home? If it had grown up, it would have made a dreadfully ugly child. But it makes a rather handsome pig, I think. Cheshire Puss. Would you tell me, please,
which way I ought to walk from here.
That depends a great deal on where you want to get to.
Well, I don't much care where.
Then it doesn't matter which way you walk.
So long as I get somewhere.
You're sure to do so if you only walk long enough.
What sort of people live about here?
To the right lives a Hatter. To the left lives a March Hare. Visit either you like. They're both mad.
But I don't want to go among mad people.
You can't help it. We are all mad. I am mad. You are mad.
How do you know I'm mad?
You must be, or you would not have come here. Do you play croquet with the Queen today?
Oh, I should like to very much, but I haven't been invited yet.
See me there.
Meow! 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 Meow!
Well, I've often seen a cat without a grin. But a grin without a cat? It's the most curious thing I've seen in all my life. I've seen hatters before. The March Hare will be much the more interesting. And as it's May, perhaps it won't be raving mad. At least, not as mad as it was in March.
No room. No, no room. No room. No room.
Must be very uncomfortable for the dormouse. Only as it's asleep, I suppose it doesn't mind.
No room. No room. No room. No room. No room.
There's plenty of room.
Have some wine.
I don't see any wine.
There isn't any.
Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it.
Wasn't very civil of you to sit down without being invited.
Oh, I didn't know it was your table. It's late for a great many more than three.
Your hair wants cutting.
You should learn not to make personal remarks. It's very rude.
Why, is a raven like a writing desk?
Well, I believe I can guess that.
Do you mean you think you can find out the answer to it?
Exactly so.
Then you should say what you mean.
I do. At least I mean what I say. It's the same thing, you know.
Not the same thing a bit. Why, you might just as well say that I see what I eat. It's the same thing as I eat what I see.
You might just as well say that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like.
Or you might just as well say that I breathe when I sleep is the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
It is the same thing with you, dormouse.
What a funny watch. It tells the days of the month, but doesn't tell what o'clock it is.
Why should it? Does your watch tell you what year it is?
No, of course not, but that's because it stays the same year for such a long time together.
Which is just the case with mine.
I don't understand you.
Have you guessed the riddle yet?
No, I give it up. What's the answer?
I haven't the slightest idea.
All right.
I think you might do something better with the time than wasting it and asking riddles that have no answers.
If you knew time as well as I do, you wouldn't talk about wasting it. It's him!
I don't know what you mean.
Of course you don't. I dare say you never even spoke to time.
No, perhaps not, but I know that I have to beat time when I learn music.
Ah, that accounts for it. He won't stand beating. Now, if you only stayed on good terms with him, he'd do almost anything you'd like with the clock.
Is that the way you manage?
Not I. We quarreled last March, just before he went mad, you know. Oh, it was at the great concert given by the Queen of Hearts. And I had to sing, "Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder what you're at." You know the song, perhaps.
I've heard something like it.
It goes on, you know, in this way. Up above the world you fly like a tea tray in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle. Well, I'd hardly finished the first verse.
Twinkle.
I'd hardly finished the first verse.
Twinkle, twinkle!
I'd hardly finished the first verse when the queen bawled out, "He's murdering time off with his head."
Oh, how dreadfully savage.
And ever since that, he won't do a thing I ask. It's always 6 o'clock now.
Is that the reason so many tea things are put here?
Yes, that's it. It's always tea time. Ah! And we've not time to wash the things between whiles.
Wake up, Dormouse!
I wasn't asleep. I heard every word you fellows were saying.
I want a clean cup. Let's all move one place on.
But I don't understand.
Then you shouldn't talk. No room. No room. No room.
At any rate, I'll never go there again. That's the stupidest tea party I ever was at in all my life. Would you tell me, please, why are you painting those roses?
Well, why, the fact is, you see, miss, this here ought to have been a red rose tree, and we put in a white one by mistake. And if the queen was to find it out, we'd all have our heads cut off, you know.
The queen.
The queen!
Idiot. What is your name, child?
My name is Alice, so please, Your Majesty.
Alice?
Why, they're only a pack of cards, after all. I needn't be afraid of them.
Who are they?
How should I know? It's no business of mine.
Off with her head. Off.
Nonsense.
I consider, my dear, she's only a child.
Turn around. Oh, leave off that. You're making me giddy. Now, what have you been doing here?
May it please Your Majesty, we were trying to...
I see. Off with their heads. Can you play croquet?
Yes.
Come on, then.
It's a fine day.
Very. Where's the Duchess?
Shh, shh.
She's under sentence of execution.
What for?
Did you say, what a pity?
No, I didn't. I don't think it's at all a pity. I said, what for?
She boxed the queen's ears. Hush. Hush. The queen will hear you. She came rather late, and the queen said...
You play croquet. Come on, then. Take your places.
Thank you.
with his head. Off with his head. Off. Alice, have you met the Mock Turtle yet?
I don't even know what a Mock Turtle is.
Well, it's the thing Mock Turtle soup is made from.
I never saw one nor heard of one.
You shall meet the Mock Turtle and hear his history. Griffin! Griffin! Up, lazy thing! Take this young lady to meet the Mock Turtle and to hear his history. I shall take care of some executions I have ordered.
It's all her fancy, that. They never execute nobody, you know. Come on.
I never was so ordered about in all my life. Never.
Ba-ba-ba-boo-boo. Ba 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 ba.
What is his sorrow?
It's all his fancy, that. He hasn't got no sorrow, you know.
Ba 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 ba. Who's that knocking?
This here young lady, she wants for to know your history, she do.
Oh, well, I'll tell it to her. Sit down. Once, I was a real turtle. When we were little, we went to school in the sea. The master was an old turtle. We used to call him Tortoise.
Why did you call him Tortoise if he wasn't one?
We called him Tortoise because he taught us. Really, you are very dull.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself for asking such a simple question.
Of course, you know, we had the best of education. In fact, we went to school every day.
Oh, I've been to day school, too. You needn't be so proud as all that.
With extras?
Yes, we learned French and music.
Oh, then yours wasn't really a good school, then. Why, at ours they had, at the end of the bill, French, music, and washing extra.
Well, you couldn't have wanted it much living at the bottom of the sea.
Well, I couldn't afford to learn it. I only took the regular course.
What was that?
Reeling and writhing, of course, to begin with. And then the different branches of arithmetic. Ambition, distraction, uglification, and derision.
Well, I never heard of uglification. What is it?
Never heard of uglification? You know what to beautify is, I suppose?
It means to make anything prettier.
Well, then, if you don't know what to uglify is, you are a simpleton.
Well, how many hours a day did you do lessons?
Oh, 10 hours the first, 9 the next, and so on.
What a curious plan.
Well, that's the reason they're called lessons. Because they... lesson from day to day.
That's right.
Then the 11th day must have been a holiday.
Oh, of course it was.
But how did you manage on the 12th?
Well,
that's enough about lessons. Tell her something about the games now.
Oh, well, it's all right.
Same as if he had a bone in his throat.
Now, you may not have lived much under the sea.
I haven't.
And perhaps you were never introduced to a lobster.
Oh, I once tasted... No, never.
Ah. So you have no idea what a delightful thing a lobster quadrille is.
No, indeed. What sort of a dance is it?
Would you like to see a little of it?
Very much indeed.
Right. Let's try the first figure. We can do it without the lobsters, you know. Which shall sing?
Oh, you sing. I've forgotten the words.
Will you walk a little faster, said a whiting to a snail. There's a porpoise close behind us, and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobsters and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on the shingle. Will you come and join the dance? Will you join the dance?
If I'd in the whiting in the song, I'd have said to the porpoise, keep back, please. We don't want you with us.
Oh, but they were obliged to have him with them. You see, no wise fish would go anywhere without a porpoise.
Wouldn't it really?
Why, of course not. Why, if a fish came to me and told me he was going on a journey, I'd say, with what porpoise? That's clever.
Don't you mean purpose?
I mean what I say.
Shall we try another figure from the lobster quadrille? Or do you want the Mock Turtle to sing you a song?
Oh, a song, please, if the Mock Turtle would be so kind.
Hmm. No accounting for taste. Singer, Turtle Soup, will you, old fellow?
Beautiful soup, so rich and green, waiting in a hot tureen. Who for such dainties would not stoop? Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Beautiful soup, who cares for fish, game, or any other dish? Who would not give all else for two? Any worth only a beautiful soup. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Soup of the evening, beautiful soup. Beautiful soup. Beautiful soup. Soup of the evening. Beautiful, beautiful.
The trial is beginning.
Come on.
What trial is it?
Come on.
That's the judge because of his great wig. And that's the jury box. And I suppose those creatures are the jurors. What are they doing? They can't have anything to put down yet before the trial's begun.
They're putting their names down for fear they should forget them. Before the end of the trial.
Stupid things.
Silence in the court.
The herald, read the accusation.
Queen of Hearts. She made some tarts, all on a summer's day. The Knave of Hearts, he stole those tarts! and took them quite away.
Oh! Oh!
No, Your Excellency, there is a great deal more to come before that.
What lovely thoughts. I wish they'd get the trial done and hand round the refreshments.
Shh. Young lady, look along the road and tell me, whom do you see?
I see nobody on the road.
I only wish I had such eyes. To see nobody at such a distance, too. It's enough for me to see real people by this light. Who did you pass on the road?
Nobody.
Quite right. She saw him, too. So nobody walks slower than you. Well, now that you've got your breath, tell us, what are they saying in town?
I'll whisper it. The trial ought to begin!
You call that a whisper? You do that again, I'll have you butted. Sit down. The first witness.
First witness!
I beg pardon, Majesty, for bringing this in, but I hadn't quite finished my tea when I was sent for.
Well, you ought to have finished. When did you begin?
14th of March, I think it was.
The 15th?
16th.
Write that down. Yes. Remove your hat.
It isn't mine.
Stolen!
I keep them to sell. I've none of my own. I'm a hatter.
Just get on with it. And don't be nervous or I'll have you executed on the spot.
A poor man, Your Majesty. I hadn't just begun my tea, not above a week or so ago. And what with the bread and the butter getting so thin, and the twinkling of the tea.
The twinkling of a what?
It began with the tea.
Well, of course, twinkling begins with the tea. Did you think I'm some sort of dunce? Well, if that's all you have to say, you may stand down.
I can't go any lower. I'm on the floor as it is.
Well, then you may sit down.
I'd rather finish my tea.
You may go.
Just take his head off outside.
Consider your verdict!
Wait. There's more evidence to come. This piece of paper has just been picked up. It's a set of verses.
Was it in the prisoner's handwriting?
No, it's not. And that is the queerest thing about it.
Well, perhaps he imitated someone else's hand.
Please, Your Majesty, I didn't write it, and he can't prove I did. There's no name signed at the end.
Well, that only makes matters worse, you see, because you must have meant some mischief, or else you would have signed your own name like an honest man. Oh, no.
That proves his guilt?
It proves nothing of the sort. Why, you don't even know what they're about.
Read them.
Where shall I begin, please, Your Majesty?
Begin at the beginning and continue until you get to the end. Then stop.
They told me you had been to her and mentioned me to him. She gave me a good character, but said I could not swim. He sent them word I had not gone. We know it to be true. If she should push the matter on, what would become of you?
I gave her one, they gave him two, you gave us three or more. They all returned from him to you, though they were mine before. I gave her one, they gave him two, you gave us three or four. They all returned from him to you, though they were mine before. If I or she should chance to be involved in this affair, he'd trust to you to set them free exactly as we were.
He'd trust to you to set them free exactly as we were.
My notion was that you had been before she had this fit, an obstacle that came between him and ourselves and it.
Before she had this fit, before she had this fit.
Don't let him know she liked them best, for this must ever be a secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me. She liked them best, for this must ever be a secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me.
For this must ever be, for this must ever be a secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me. A secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me. A secret kept from all the rest, a secret kept from all the rest, a secret kept from all the rest, from all the rest and me.
So please now let the jury...
If any of them can explain it, I'll give him sixpence. I don't believe there's an atom of meaning in it.
She doesn't believe there's an atom of meaning in it.
What do you know about this business?
Nothing.
Nothing whatever?
Nothing whatever.
But that's very important.
Unimportant.
Unimportant. I meant, of course, unimportant. 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 Consider your verdict!
No, no.
No, no.
Sentence first.
Sentence first.
Verdict.
Verdict.
Afterwards.
Afterwards.
Stuff and nonsense. The idea of having the sentence first.
Hold your tongue.
I won't.
Off with her head!
Off with her head? On with her head. Off 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 with her head.
Curtain in 15 minutes.
Going and where do you come from? Look up, speak nicely, and don't twiddle your fingers.
You see, I've lost my way.
I don't know what you mean by your way. All the ways about here belong to me. But why did you come here at all? Curtsy while you're thinking what to answer. It saves time. It's time for you to answer now. Open your mouth a little wider when you speak and always say, Your Majesty.
I only wanted to see what the garden was like. Oh, Your Majesty.
That's right. Though when you say gardens, I've seen gardens compared with which this would be a wilderness.
And I thought I'd try and find my way to the top of that hill.
You say hill. I could show you hills in comparison with which you would call that a valley.
No, I shouldn't. A hill can't be a valley, you know. That would be nonsense.
You may call it nonsense, but I've heard nonsense compared with which that would be as sensible as a dictionary.
Oh, I declare. It's marked out like a large chessboard. It's a great, huge game of chess that's being played all over the world. If this is the world at all, you know. Oh, what fun it is. How I wish I were a part of it. I wouldn't mind being a pawn, if only I might join. Though, of course, I should like to be a queen best.
That's easily managed, you know. You can be the White Queen's pawn, if you like. You'd be in the second square to begin with. And when you get to the eighth square, you'll be a queen. Faster, faster!
Wonder if all the things move along with us.
Faster, don't try to talk!
Are we nearly there?
Nearly there! Why, we passed it 10 minutes ago! Rest for a little if you'd like.
I declare, we've been under this tree the whole time. Everything's just as it was.
Of course it is. How would you have it?
Well, in our country, you generally get to somewhere else if you ran very fast for a long time as we've been doing.
Oh, a slow sort of country. Now here, you see, it takes all the running you can do to keep in the same place. And if you want to get somewhere else, you must run at least twice as fast as that.
Oh, I'd rather not try, please. I'm quite content to stay here. Only, I am so hot and thirsty.
Oh, I know what you want. Have a biscuit? While you are refreshing yourself, I shall give you your directions. Have another biscuit?
Oh, no, thank you. One's quite enough.
Thirst quenched, I hope. Now, the pawn goes two squares in its first move, you know. So you'll go very quickly through the third square, and you'll find yourself in the fourth square in no time. Well, that square belongs to Tweedledum and Tweedledee. The fifth square is mostly water. The sixth square belongs to... Humpty Dumpty. But you make no remark.
Well, I didn't know I had to make one just then.
You could have said. It is very kind of you to tell me all of these things. However, we will suppose that it has been said. The seventh square is all forest. However, one of the knights will show you the way. And when you reach the eighth square, we shall be queens together. And it is all feasting and fun and... Speak French when you can't think of the English for it. Turn your toes out when you walk. And remember who you are. Goodbye.
She can run very fast.
If you think we're waxworks, you ought to pay, you know. Waxworks are not made for looking at for nothing, nohow.
Contrarywise, if you think we're alive, you ought to speak.
Sure, I'm very sorry.
I know what you're thinking, and it isn't so, nohow.
Contrarywise, if it was so, it might be. If it were so, it would be. But as it isn't, it ain't. That's the logic.
Well, I was thinking, which is the best way out of this wood, for it's coming on very dark. Would you tell me, please?
Do you like poetry?
Yes, pretty well. Some poetry.
What shall we repeat to her? Oh, the walrus and the carpenter. That's longest.
The sun was shining on the sea, shining with all his might. He did his very best to make the billows smooth and bright. And this was odd because it was the middle of the night.
The walrus and the carpenter were walking close at hand.
They wept like anything to see such quantities of sand.
If this were only cleared away, they said it would be grand. Oysters, come and walk with us. The walrus did beseech. A pleasant walk, a pleasant talk along the briny beach. We cannot do with more than four to give a hand to each. The eldest oyster looked at him, but never a word he said. The eldest oyster winked his eye and shook his heavy head, meaning to say he did not choose to leave his oyster bed. But four young oysters hurried up, all eager for their treat. Their coats were brushed, their faces washed, their shoes were clean and neat. And this was odd because, you know, they hadn't any feet. For other oysters followed them, and yet another four. And thick and fast they came at last, and more and more and more. All hopping through the frothy waves and scrambling to the shore. The walrus and the carpenter walked on a mile or so, and then they rested on a rock conveniently low. And all the little oysters stood and waited in a row. The time has come, the walrus said, to talk of many things, of shoes and sheets and sealing wax, of cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot and where the pigs have wings. A loaf of bread, the walrus said, is what we chiefly need. Pepper and vinegar, besides, are very good indeed. Now, if you're ready, oysters dear, we can begin to feed. But not on us, the oysters cried, turning a little blue. After such kindness, that would be a dismal thing to do. The night is fine, the walrus said. Do you admire the view?
It seems a shame, the walrus said, to play them such a trick. After we brought them out so far and made them trot so quick.
The carpenter said nothing, but the butter spread too thick.
Dance!
I weep for you, the walrus said, I deeply sympathize. With sobs and tears, he sorted out those of the largest size. Holding his pocket handkerchief before his streaming eyes.
Oh, oyster, said the carpenter, you've had a pleasant run. Shall we be trotting home again?
But answer came there none. But answer came there none.
And this was scarcely odd, because they'd eaten everyone.
At any rate, I'd really better be getting out of this wood, for it's coming on very dark. Do you think it's going to rain?
No, I don't. Leastways, not under here, nohow.
But it may rain outside.
It may if it chooses. We've no objection, contrarywise.
somebody's shawl been blown off. I'm glad I happened to be in the way.
Bread and butter, bread and butter, bread and butter.
Am I addressing the White Queen?
Well, yes. If you call that addressing, it's not my notion of the thing at all.
If Your Majesty will only tell me the right way to begin, I'll do it as well as I can.
I don't want it done at all. I've been addressing myself for the last 2 hours.
Every single thing's crooked here, and she is all over pins. May I put your shawl straight for you?
Oh, I don't know what's the matter with it. It's out of temper, I think. I pinned it here, I pinned it there. There's no pleasing it.
Well, it can't go straight, you know, if you pin it all on one side like that. Oh, dear me, what a state your hair is in.
Oh, the brush has got entangled in, and I lost the comb yesterday.
Well, come. You look rather better now. But really, you should have a lady's maid.
Oh, I'm sure. I'll take you with pleasure. Tuppence a week and jam every other day.
Oh, I don't want you to hire me, and I don't care for jam.
It's very good jam.
Well, I don't want any today, at any rate.
Well, you couldn't have it even if you wanted it. The rule is jam yesterday, jam tomorrow, but never jam today.
It must come sometimes to jam today.
But it can't. It's jam every other day. And today isn't any other day, you know.
I don't understand you. It's dreadfully confusing.
Oh. That's the effect of living backwards, I guess. It always makes one a little giddy at first.
Living backwards? I never heard of such a thing.
There's one great advantage in it, that one's memory works both ways.
I'm sure mine only works one way. I can't remember things before they happen.
It's a poor sort of memory that only works backwards.
Well, what sort of things do you remember best?
I remember things that happened the week after next. For instance, now, take the king's messenger. He's in prison being punished. And the trial doesn't even begin until Wednesday. And, of course, the crime, well, that comes last of all.
Suppose he never commits the crime.
Well, that would be all the better, wouldn't it?
Well, it would be all the better. But it wouldn't be all the better his being punished for it.
Oh, you're wrong there, at any rate. Were you ever punished?
Yes, but then I had done the things I was being punished for. That makes all the difference.
But if you hadn't done them, that would be better still. Better and better and better and better and better.
Oh, there's a mistake here somewhere.
Oh, my finger's bleeding. Oh.
What is the matter? Have you pricked your finger?
Oh, I haven't pricked it yet, but I soon shall. Oh.
When do you expect to do it?
When I fasten my shawl again. The pin will come undone directly. Oh, take care.
You're holding it all crooked. Oh.
That accounts for the bleeding, you see. Now you understand the way things happen here.
Why don't you scream now?
I've already done all the screaming. What would be the good of having it all over again?
Well, I'm glad it's getting lighter. I thought it was the night coming on.
Oh, I wish I could manage to be glad. I never can remember the rule. Oh, you must be happy here in this wood. Being glad whenever you like.
Only it's so very lonely here.
Now, don't go on like that. Consider what a great girl you are. Consider what a long way you've come today. Consider what a clock it is. Consider anything. Only don't cry.
Can you keep from crying by considering things?
That's the way it's done. Nobody can do two things at once. Now, let's consider your age to begin with. How old are you?
I'm 7 and a half exactly.
You don't have to say exactly. I can believe it without that. Now I'll give you something to believe. I am 101, 5 months and 1 day.
I can't believe that.
You can't?
No.
Well, try again. Take a long breath and shut your eyes.
There's no use in trying. One can't believe impossible things.
Oh, I dare say you haven't had much practice. When I was your age, I did it a half an hour every day. Sometimes I could believe as many as 6 impossible things before breakfast. Oh, there goes the shawl. I've got it. Now you shall see me pin it again, all by myself.
Then I hope your finger is better now.
Much better, much better. Better, 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 better.
Dumpty himself. It can't be anybody else. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
Don't stand chattering to yourself like that. But tell me your name and your business.
My name is Alice.
Oh, it's a stupid name enough. What does it mean?
Must a name mean something?
Well, of course it must. My name means the shape I am, and a good, handsome shape it is, too. With a name like yours, you might be any shape almost. How old did you say you were?
7 years and 6 months.
Wrong. You never said a word like it.
I thought you meant how old are you?
If I'd meant that, I'd have said that. 7 years and 6 months, an uncomfortable sort of age. Now, if you'd asked my advice, I'd have said, leave off at 7. But it's too late now.
You seem very clever at explaining words, sir. Perhaps you could tell me the meaning of the poem called Jabberwocky.
Let's hear it. I can explain all the poems that ever were invented, and a good many that haven't been invented just yet.
"'Twas brillig, and the slithy toves did gyre and gimble in the wabe. All mimsy were the borogoves, and the mome raths outgrabe."
That's enough to begin with. There are plenty of hard words there. Brillig means 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The time you begin broiling things for dinner.
And slithy?
Well, slithy means lithe and slimy. You see, it's like a portmanteau. There are 2 meanings packed up into 1 word.
And what does outgrabe mean?
Well, outgrabing is something between bellowing and whistling with a kind of a sneeze in the middle. However, you'll hear it done. Maybe. And when you've once heard it, you'll be quite content.
Is that all?
That's all. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Till we meet again.
Oh, I shouldn't know you again if we didn't meet. You're so exactly like other people. Now, if you had the 2 eyes on the same side of the nose, for instance, or the mouth on top, that would be some help.
It wouldn't look nice.
Wait till you've tried.
Goodbye! Of all the unsatisfactory, of all the unsatisfactory people I've ever met.
Now one can breathe more easily. I wonder if you... Thank you. Thank you. I see you're admiring my little box. It's my own invention to keep clothes and sandwiches in. You see, I carry it upside down so that the rain can't get in.
But the things can get out. You know the lid's open.
I did not know it. And all the things must have fallen out, and the box is no use without them. Can you guess why I did that? In hopes some bees may nest in it, and I should get the honey. I hope you got your hair well fastened on.
Only in the usual way.
Ah, that's hardly enough. You see, the wind is so very strong here. It's as strong as soup.
Have you invented a plan for keeping the hair from being blown off?
Not yet, but I have a plan for keeping hair from falling off.
I should like to hear it very much.
Well, first you get an upright stick. Then you make your hair creep up it like a fruit tree. You see, the reason things fall off is because they hang down. Things never fall upwards, you know. It's a little plan of my own invention. You may try it if you like. You look sad. Let me sing you a song to comfort you.
Is it very long?
It is long, but it's very, very beautiful. Everybody who's heard me sing it, either it brings tears to their eyes or else...
Or else what?
Or else it doesn't, you know. The song is called A Sitting on a Gate. And the tune is my own invention.
I'll tell thee everything I can. There's little to relate. I saw an aged, aged man a-sitting on a gate. He said, I look for butterflies that sleep among the wheat. I make them into mutton pies and sell them in the street. But I was thinking of a way to feed oneself on batter and so go on from day to day, getting a little fatter. He said, I hunt for haddock's eyes among the heather bright and work them into waistcoat buttons in the silent night. And that's the way he gave a wink by which I get my wealth. And very gladly will I drink your honor's noble health. I thanked him much for telling me the way he got his wealth, but chiefly for his wish that he might drink my noble health. And now if e'er by chance I put my fingers into glue, or madly squeeze a right-hand foot into a left-hand shoe, or if I drop upon my toe a very heavy weight, I weep, for it reminds me so of that old man I used to know, whose look was mild, whose speech was slow, whose hair was whiter than the snow, whose face was very like a crow, with eyes like cinders all aglow, who seemed distracted with his woe, who rocked his body to and fro, and muttered mumblingly and low, as if his mouth were full of dough, who snorted like a buffalo. That summer evening, long ago, a-sitting on a gate.
And now I must be going. But you'll stay and see me off. Ah, thank you. You'll wait and wave your handkerchief when I get to that turn in the road. I think it would encourage me, you see.
Of course I'll wait. And thank you for the song. I liked it very much.
I hope so, but you didn't cry as much as I thought you would. Yoice. Yoice. Tally ho.
I hope it encouraged him. And now, for the eighth square, and to be a queen! This on my head, and how can it have got there without my knowing it? Well, this is grand. I never expected I should be a queen so soon, and if I really am a queen, I shall be able to manage it quite well in time. Would you tell
me,
please?
Speak when spoken to. And what do you mean by if you really are a queen? What right have you to speak of yourself so? You cannot be a queen until you have passed the proper examination. And the sooner we begin it, the better.
I only said if.
She says she only said if.
But she said a great deal more than that. Ever so much more than that.
You did, you know. Always speak the truth. Think before you speak and write it down afterwards.
Well, I'm sure I didn't mean.
That's just what I complain of. You should have meant. What do you suppose is the use of a child without meaning? Even a joke should have some meaning. And a child is more important than a joke, I hope. You couldn't deny that even if you tried with both hands.
I don't deny things with my hands.
Nobody said you did. I said you couldn't if you tried.
She's in that state of mind where she wants to deny something, only she cannot think what to deny.
A nasty, vicious temper. I invite you to Alice's dinner party this afternoon.
and I invite you.
Well, I didn't know I was to have a party at all, but if there is to be one, I think I ought to invite the guests.
We gave you the opportunity to do it, but I dare say you have not had many lessons in manners yet.
Well, manners are not taught in lessons. Lessons teach you to do sums and things of that sort.
Can you do addition? Mm-hmm. What is one and 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 one?
Oh, I don't know. I lost count.
She can't do addition. Can you do subtraction? Take a bone from a dog, what remains?
Well, the bone wouldn't remain, of course, if I took it. And the dog wouldn't remain. It would come to bite me, and I'm sure I shouldn't remain.
Then you think nothing would remain?
I think that's the answer.
Wrong! As usual, the dog's temper would remain.
I don't see how.
Why, look here! The dog would lose its temper, wouldn't it?
Perhaps it would.
Then when the dog went away, its temper would remain.
They might go different ways. What dreadful nonsense we are talking.
She can't do sums a bit.
Can you do sums?
I can do addition if you give me time. Mm-hmm. But I cannot do subtraction under any circumstances.
Mm-hmm. Of course you know your ABCs.
To be sure I do.
So do I, dear. We'll do them together often. And I'll tell you a secret. I can read words of one letter. Isn't that grand? Oh, don't be discouraged. You'll come to it in time.
Can you answer useful questions? How do you make bread?
I know that. You take some flour.
Where do you pick the flour? In the garden or in the hedges?
Oh, it isn't picked at all. It's ground.
How many acres of ground? You mustn't leave out so many things.
Oh, fan her head. She's getting feverish with too much thinking. Ah, there, she's all right again now. Do you know languages?
Yes.
What is the French for fiddle-dee-dee?
Fiddle-dee-dee is not English.
Whoever said it was?
Well, if you'll tell me what language fiddle-dee-dee is, I'll tell you the French for it.
Queens never make bargains.
I wish queens never asked questions.
Don't let us quarrel. What is the cause of lightning?
The cause of lightning is the thunder. Oh, no, no, I mean the other way!
It's too late to correct it now. When you have said a thing, that fixes it, and you must take the consequences.
That reminds me. We had such a thunderstorm last Tuesday. The last set of Tuesdays, I mean.
Well, in our country, you only have one day at a time.
Pooh. That's a poor, thin way of doing things. Now, here, we mostly have days and nights, two and three at a time. Sometimes in the winter, we take as many as five nights together. For the warmth, you know.
Are five nights warmer than one night, then?
Five times as warm.
It was such a storm that I can't think.
Your Majesty must forgive her. She means well. She can't help saying foolish things as a general rule. She really was never well brought up. But it's amazing how good-tempered she is. Pat her head. See how pleased she'll be. Oh, a little kindness and putting her hair in papers will do wonders for her.
I'm so sleepy.
Oh, poor thing. Smooth her hair. Lend her your nightcap and sing her a soothing lullaby.
I haven't got a nightcap with me and I don't know any lullabies.
I must do it myself then.
Hush-a-bye, lady in Alice's lap. Till the feast ready, we've time for a nap. When the feast's over, we'll go to the ball. Red Queen and White Queen and Alice and all. Now you know the birds. Just sing it to me. I'm getting sleepy too.
What am I to do? Do wake up, you heavy things. Which bell must I ring? I'm not a visitor and I'm not a servant. There ought to be one more queen, you know.
Thank you.
all drink to your health. To Queen Alice's health.
Queen Alice's health.
You ought to return thanks in a neat speech.
We have to support you, you know.
I rise to return thanks. I rise to return thanks.
Faster. Faster. Faster.
Take
care of yourself. Something's going to happen.
Please, curtain going up.
Twas brillig. And the slithy toves did gyre and gimble in the wabe. All mimsy were the borogoves and the mome raths outgrabe. Beware the jabberwock, my son, the jaws that bite, the claws that catch. Beware the jubjub bird and shun the frumious bandersnatch. He took his vorpal sword in hand. Long time the manxome foe he sought. So rested he by the tum-tum tree and stood awhile in thought. And as in uffish thought he stood, the jabberwock with eyes aflame came whiffling through the tulgey wood and burbled as it came. One, two, one, two. And through the vorpal blade went snicker-snack. He left it dead, and with its head he went galumphing back. And hast thou slain the Jabberwock? Come to my arms, my beamish boy. O frabjous day, Calloo, Callay, he chortled in his joy. 'Twas brillig, and the slithy toves did gyre and gimble in the wabe. All mimsy were the borogoves, and the mome raths outgrabe.